Hello, you know the drill. I don't need to say much. This is How to Rhino, and this is video number 21. This is an advanced beginners video. If you are interested in the series, please check the link here. We are still in the surface tools. We'll stay there for a while. Today we'll look into surface offsets and planar surface boolean. Actually, never tried it. I know how it works, but I never used it. I should actually use it more. And then let's see how far we get. You might remember this from last time. Surface tool, control points are powerful. Remember? Offset, pretty straightforward. You just click this here. You can then define lots of stuff as usual. You have this menu here on the top. Very important is the distance. You need to define the distance. You also need to check in which direction you want to offset your surface. In that case, that's correct, but if you wanted to offset in the other direction, you just click on the surface and it shows you the direction it will offset. Then you can also delete input. I don't want to do that. I don't want to delete the input. And you can also offset both sides. That's also possible. I don't want to do that either. The tolerance, it's about how accurate it is. You can test these things for yourself. Loose, is it loose? Yes or no? I actually have tried this. So let's try these few of them. Solid, I know what it means. That means that it actually becomes a solid object. We can try these. Okay, let's find a reasonable distance. Let's say 2 meters. Working with meter here, and you can always also type the you can always also type whatever is here underlined. You can type solid, S for solid, D for distance, and so on. Distance, I can let's change it to 3. Corner, round, solid, yes, let's keep this. Loose, no. And then I can just click. You can see it actually creates some weird stuff. Let's try this again. Let's fix this here a bit. It's not so extreme. Yeah, there's a bit of a problem here. And this is because there's these control points. You can see the control points are actually making a bit of an issue here. So I pull this back so they're not overlapping. And now it should actually work. Okay, let's try this again. Yeah, much better. So you can see, create this solid offset, or create an offset and then combine the whole thing as a solid object. Now I can also turn off the isocurves, so it's a bit more nicer to look at. My material is a bit too shiny, I have to say. But I like it. Let's get rid of the shininess a bit. Not so much different. Yeah, there's nothing more to say to that, really. Well, let's go back. Let's delete some of these. We don't need that. I'll keep this. Looks quite cool. Okay, so let's do this again. Offset. You can also type it. So that would be what I would do. Offset surface. Distance 5 meters. Okay. Now, let's try the other options here. Round corners, sharp corners. Not sure it's... I can actually see it here. I don't need to show it extra. But if you have a corner in your surface, then it would create a round corner. The offset would then be rounder. Makes sense. Now it makes sense. Loose. It just offsetted the isocurves as they are, which results in an object with less control points. So it could be quite. So I guess these are more accurate than this one. But this has other advantages. So less control points means also easier to modify. And then let's see what else. That's it. Both sides, you can imagine, it's just thicker. Okay, let's do this. Delete input. Let's do that. So I deleted the inside and just extended both sides and combined it to a solid. And if you don't want to have a solid, then you just then it's just it just offsets one surface. Okay, this tool is super interesting. Let's draw some shapes here. Okay, so these are all surfaces, planar surfaces, and now the problem is that they overlap, and if you want to combine them, then you can actually combine them like this, and it became one surface. How cool is that? How cool is this? Okay, let's do this trick again. See, they are all, I will remove the isocurves here because they're quite annoying, and I will make a copy again so we can see the difference. So combining. Can combine all of them. Funny thing, it's turned on. Remove, subtract these, and then the intersection. What if I want to intersect more? That doesn't work. Also, I want to show all of these. That was not cool. Man, what I'm doing here. And we can also do, we can show it like this. That's also fine. Union coplanar surfaces. So coplanar, I would call it Boolean. Now, I'm curious if I would see the control points here. Yes, look at that. Actually, the control points here kind of still has the full set of control points. But yeah, pretty interesting. Last but not least, let's have a look at the variable offset surface. That's also interesting. Let's have a first simple surface. And now you can just move your curves like the control points. Basically, also uses the control points. Okay, let's try this again, and let's see if we can tolerance flip. Why can't it be solid as well? But if you want to have it solid, there's also a way to do that. So you could either draw surfaces in here. That's possible. So it's just one way to do it. I've worked a bit sloppy here, you can see, but you get the point. We will look in how to fix things like that in another video. But so let's see, let's say if this is a bit more complicated object, then it's always then perpendicular to that orientation of the control point. I'm not sure if I like this. I mean, I could just make a copy of that. I don't like it that you can't make it solid, just like that. It's a bit annoying. I mean, it is cool. No offense here. And you could still try to close that. Now let's try a different method. Do this here. That maybe even works much better than the previous version. So I could use this one. Surface from 2, 3, or 4 edge curves. Upla. Extrusion. In that case, I would also because I have a line here, I have a curve here, right? I would not use the curve just in case the surface I created is not entirely on the curve. That would be an issue because then I create a surface on the curve but not on the edge, and then it doesn't close. Yeah, I think you can still create quite cool stuff with it. You can also extract this here. And let's try something else. Now I have more control points here, it seems like. Yes, I have a lot more. So now I'll make a copy. And now if I do the same, let's see what happens. Oh, no, this. It's interesting. It does not give me the option. Ah, here. Add handle. You can add more points if you want. And even on the surface. Randomly. That's pretty cool. Okay. Now I can modify these. Just the way I want. Okay, let's try this again. Yeah, I think you get the point. Nevertheless, so I think we learned something new. See you in the next video.